Hey everybody, it's Adrian from the channel 8Spade13. Today is another installment of What's in My Crate. And today we are going to listen to Roxy Music's debut album, Roxy Music. I was somewhat obsessed with this album. Because I really liked Roxy Music, and I think the first time I ever heard of them was when I think I watched the movie Casino back in the day, and they had a song called Love is a Drug, and I really liked that song, and it just kind of stuck in my head for a long time. And I think probably about 10 years ago, I started doing a lot of research into music, and I discovered this album, which, you know, really, you know, I liked it a lot. So I'm gonna play a couple songs from it, two that I really particularly enjoy, and I hope you enjoy them too. And afterwards we'll talk a little more about it.
Thank you.
Okay, so that was two songs from Roxy Music's debut album. Well, on the back here it says the first Roxy Music album, and that's what's actually on the record underneath their name. But, you know, people just call it the debut album. But anyway, yeah, I played two songs. I played If There Is Something and 2HB, which is basically to Humphrey Bogart, because I mean, you can tell the song is about Humphrey Bogart when the lyric is, you know, here's looking at you, kid. But anyway, this is considered a glam rock album, you know, probably one of the first ones back, because in 72, that's when, you know, David Bowie released Ziggy Stardust, and then from there on, it kind of started a craze with, you know, guys dressing up in women's clothes and, you know, the whole androgyny thing, the makeup, you know. But it, I mean, it was great music. It's a very good genre to check out. There's a lot of good music involved in that movement. Very arty, very glamorous, very, you know, but it was all rock and roll, you know. I just watched that Stardust movie, which was kind of a piece of crap, but I mean, it did kind of, you know, explain how Bowie got into, you know, the whole Ziggy Stardust alien thing. But anyway, I'm going off subject. Yeah, this is 72, which was a very, very good year for music. I mean, a lot of the stuff that I have in my collection is from 1972. I think that the 70s were a very, very good year, or good era for music, because good decade. I think it was because people were really pushing the envelope. You know, 60s, everybody was just trying to make hits. You know, the record companies were heavily involved in, you know, the style of music, the lyrics and all that. They were, you know, telling them what they could and could not do. And then the 70s came, and, you know, there was a whole lot of drugs and a whole lot of, you know, imagination, and people were making concept albums, and, you know, I mean, it was just really, really good time, just when people were breaking away from, you know, the regular, you know, kind of music and all that. But yeah, this is a very, very good album. I don't have a whole lot of Roxy Music. I need to buy more Roxy Music. It's just that when I was at the record store in Harlingen, this one came up. You know, I was just, you know, thumbing through, and I saw this, and I kind of freaked out and immediately put it underneath my thing and just kept going, you know, because I didn't want anybody else to try to take it from me. But anyway, yeah, so this is a very, very good album. There's more good songs on here, obviously. Remake, Remodel is a good song. Virginia Plain, The Bob. The last part of part two, or last, you know, end of it, I'm not really too familiar with it. I try to listen to the whole thing, you know, when I buy something, you know, whatever, for whatever reason I bought it for, I try to just go through the whole thing and then make a judgment, you know, because there's just no way you can just judge a whole album off of one song, you know. And this one's got a lot of good songs, so I recommend that you check it out, and whether you're on YouTube or if you can go to a record store and get a copy, and this is really good. This particular copy is, it was released later on Atlantic, but it was originally released on Island Records. So if you can find the one on Island, then, you know, you got a pretty good copy there. Yeah, so I don't know what else I have to say about it. All I suggest is to get it, and I'm going to be doing more, I'm going to be doing more videos, particularly on glam, probably. You know, I have more glam records I want to go through. Tomorrow is Friday, so I believe I'm going to do a 45 Friday tomorrow, and I'm going to go dig through my 45s, and I'm going to find at least two or three to play. And I'm going to try to see if I can make it kind of like a, you know, like a, you know, group them together for a particular reason. But anyway, thank you for tuning in. always like and subscribe and, you know, comment, you know, please leave a comment. If you got something to say about this, you know, let's just start a conversation about it. And, yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow.